Hey everybody, welcome back to Pixel Junkies. We're playing the Russian Consulate with two fucking lions.
Yeah.
Rawr.
And Jordan here is again here this week.
Probably for the last time ever.
Maybe. I don't know when the last time Jordan did a series video.
It's been a while.
Apart from the stint on this series, it was probably James Bond. Or maybe it was even when we did The Listener, and he told Rory he was the worst fucking player of Oblivion ever.
You're the worst fucking player this game I've ever seen.
To be fair.
Yes.
I don't think Rory's ever been as mad as he was at us at the end. I think that might be one of the reasons why he decided to kind of take a step back from the channel.
That's why he moved to the other side of the country.
Yeah. That's why he's not in videos anymore, by the way. He moved.
Yeah.
Definitely no other reason.
Where did he move?
He moved on to London.
That's not the other side of the country. I didn't know where he moved.
The other side of the country to be emphatic.
Yeah.
Oh.
But he moved to Ontario, which is really not that far away. Well, I mean, compared to Europe, it's far away. To Canada, it's like you're like a third of the way across.
Yeah, I've driven. I haven't been to London yet, but I have.
London, Ontario, not London, the good one.
Yeah. London, Ontario, I think, is a nice place.
Yeah, but it's not London, the good one.
Yeah, no. But I don't know how good the London, the good one is.
It's pretty good, although it won't be at the end of at the end of this month when they're
Brexit is finished.
When they kicked out of the EU and they have no fucking plan.
Oh shit!
I don't know what's gonna happen. Boris Johnson
is the biggest fucking asshole in the world.
Boris Johnson.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's actually one of the coolest things that in this game that I like.
Wow.
When you shoot fabric, it ripples. And then there's a little bullet hole in it.
Did they do the same thing they did for the original SoCan with this game?
The what?
What?
The original SoCan. In the original SoCan game.
SoCan?
Special
SOCOM. SoCOM.
SoCOM.
Sorry, SoCan. SoCan is the Songwriters Association of Canada. Which is spelt wrong, but it doesn't mean that. But anyway, SoCOM. In the original SoCOM, they went out like and field tested and did like the foley for the actual guns that they were using in game, like based on the distances that they were shooting and all that stuff. Like, they went
the sound design in this game and the second one is really good. So
I will always say that this game has great sound design. I said that right from the beginning.
But that chandelier doesn't come down.
Well, no.
Fuck that.
I agree.
That should come down.
It doesn't have insane environmental damage, although
you can shoot the shit
out of a lot of the walls.
I tripped and bonked his head. Like, ow! Fuck! I'm pretty sure I made that joke like 80 times.
That's gone.
That's cool.
That's just a bit of mercury getting down your lungs. Don't need to worry
about
that.
It's good for you until it poisons your brain.
This is good for you.
Yeah, eat it, man. Aaron, do
you remember our junior high school teacher and her story about mercury?
No.
She was like, we used to just play with mercury when we were kids. And I was like, what? It's like, yeah, they just put it in our hands and we just fuck around with it. And we were like, this is not real. She's like, yeah, no, I probably got mercury poison one.
I think that was grade 9.
I think so, yeah. It was definitely junior high.
There's this comic artist I read online who had a similar story where she was playing in her grandmother's house and she found an old thermometer. So she thought it was, she broke it open by accident and then she was playing around with fucking mercury and
stuff. Yeah, dad has stories like that.
So her grandmother came down, her kid, and this like 7-year-old kid was covered in fucking mercury. So she freaked
out.
And then so nothing came of it except for like 10 years later, she had a stroke in the middle of her classroom. And one of her eyes went like, changed color or whatever the fuck.
Was she like, mercury, and then collapsed?
No. Then, apparently, like, apparently she just had a. Anyway, so she's had a couple of strokes since. Anyway.
Jesus.
Yeah, and she. The reason I'm kind of joking about it is because she jokes about it in her comics. But in all honesty, it's a pretty serious thing. Aaron, you're ruining the earth.
I'm improving on it, even though it's bulletproof apparently, but ripples.
They're just.
What do you want to bet that this is like Wildlands concept art?
So in the same class, we had a substitute one time, and this guy was like the coolest guy ever. And he comes in and he's like this badass teacher who doesn't realize that he can't curse the junior high students. So he's like,
yeah, I was. I remember one day I was working in an office and this lady comes out to me and she's like, look, my husband was collecting this stuff and I don't know where it came from. And he's like, get the fuck out of my office. And he was trying to be all cool and everything. And we were like, and he builds it up with like suspense. He's like, It was a jar full of mercury. It was so fucked up. And I was like, you shouldn't talk like that in a class of grade nines.
So I don't remember stupid. That at all.
No? Well, maybe, I don't know if were we in the same science class?
In grade nine, I believe so.
Miss Da, I feel like it wasn't Da.
No, it was Miss Ball in grade nine.
Yeah, you're right, Miss Ball. So Miss Ball had substitute for like a couple of days, and this guy came in and wrecked house.
I think it was Miss Da, but then she left because she got offered a better job.
No, she got pregnant.
Oh, was it?
I think so.
I thought she got offered a better job, and I was like, thank fuck, because you're a shit teacher.
She was funny. Oh, we had Miss Ball.
Yeah, I remember Miss Ball.
But there was another one, too. Miss, fuck, I don't remember her name now.
Elliot?
Oh,
yeah. Missy Elliott. Have you heard her new album?
No, it's the crap.
I thought she died, like, 20 years ago.
But no, put my thing now, flip it in reverse. It. You're up for many for playing yes. Like, you know.
What? Yeah, that was, like, 1994. That was.
I know, but that was a great song. But that was all she had. Blah, 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 blah. I put my thing down, flip it in reverse. It's just your minifable in yet.
Okay.
If you play that backwards.
Oh.
If you play it backwards.
Oh, she's real clever. Oh.
Is that what that is?
Yeah. If you play it backwards, it's I put my thing down, flip it in reverse. Say, you know, if you never bring you this.
Well, that
you'll find that my backwards talk is pretty good. Because Ouya Cuff. Fuck, are you.
Didn't we do something with Ouya Cuff at one point?
Yes.
We recorded it or
Who?
Something?
Yes.
Remember,
it was at Thomas's, though.
Was it at Thomas's?
Yeah, I got everybody to say Ouya Cuff.
Oh, right, I remember.
And then played
that.
It backwards.
Oh.
Fuck you!
I don't remember.
I remember Jordan forcing us to do that. He's like, isn't this the most hilarious thing? And we're like, yeah, it's funny.
Like, calm down.
Response to Vrain.
Oh, I think I remember that now, yeah. God, stop bringing back all these memories I put in the trash bin.
Aaron's rooting through his fucking system file.
Why do you still have that?
No, like I just did it. I just did it.
Oh.
I just recorded it. Fuck you.
Like that, Jordan's had like 18 phones since then, but he's still got all this shit on.
It's weird that I have so many
things that one, too?
I slammed this one in a door.
Why?
I didn't mean to, so it's destroyed. But in the bottom corner there. Basically,
Jesus
so
Christ.
this is what happened. I had a life-proof case, right?
Apparently not.
No, I had a life-proof case on my phone, and every time I call somebody, they're like, you sound like you're underwater, and I was like, okay, I'll just get a new fucking case. So the fucking first day,
isn't that why you
new
got
case.
A new phone?
What?
I thought that was why you got a new phone originally, and apparently it was just your case.
Yes. It was my case. anyway, so...
$700 solution to a problem that
well,
doesn't fit.
Well, I was up for a new renewal, so I was like, it doesn't really count, but, anyway, the first day I put this shitty case on, I'm getting in the car, we're in Cornerbrook, and I close the door, and my phone is in my jacket, normally it's in my front pocket, so it's like close to my body.
And if you're
so
unfamiliar
in my jacket,
with Jordan, he
and
has
the jacket's
his phone
hanging
and a
out.
Tether to a car battery in his pocket.
No, the fucking... Oh yeah, Jesus Christ.
What?
I used to have those little fucking chargers. I just walk around with it.
He had this like massive car battery phone charger in his pocket, tethered to his phone. So his phone would be flinging around because it was connected to the battery. And he's like, oh, whatever. And I can't drop it because it was connected. It's just like, Jesus Christ.
No, in this case, it was just in my jacket normally, and which it normally isn't. And I went to close the door, and I go, and it was the worst. Like, I instantly knew what happened, obviously, but I was like, fuck.
So when I dropped
like
my old
first
phone,
day on, tour.
I had my old phone for 4 years, and I dropped it on the ground, and a couple of months ago, and it landed face down, and it's not the first time it's landed face down, but this time I knew, like, that screen is fucked, and I took it out, and sure enough, that screen was fucked. And then I got my new phone, which I'm very pleased with.
Can you, Malay?
Who?
What did you pronounce like that for?
Could what do you mean?
It's, well, normally you pronounce it melee, don't you?
Oh, can you melee, yes.
Melee.
Aaron, you killed a fish, dude.
Yeah, whatever.
Not whatever, they were fish.
Yeah, well, I've killed a bunch.
He doesn't give he doesn't give a fuck about the souls of living creatures.
So, Jordan,
you
I killed
shot
a fish
that
on
moose
your
in the head or whatever.
Yeah. Happy birthday, I just slaughtered thousands of fish. Fuck, cost a cod moratorium.
Oh man, a
Happy
Russian
birthday.
Oh. Did that?
Oh my god, the Ruska doll.
That's kind of funny, actually.
Your dad's out in the boat somewhere calling you. I was like, happy birthday. Fuck the COD moratorium. And starts fucking dynamite into the water.
Oh, man. It's brutal. Can you melee?
Yes, but it doesn't really do much damage.
Why doesn't it do much damage? It should kill them instantly.
Because it's a fist versus an assault rifle.
Oh, you can't get a knife?
No.
Why?
Oh, that guy ate shit. I don't know, Jordan asked me.
Also,
I didn't realize that when you shot the Russian doll, it took the outer layer off of it.
That was amazing. Yeah. The Rushka doll. I can't remember what they're actually called.
Babushka. No.
There's a Russian nesting dolls.
Yeah, but there's...
Mitrushka? Vitrushkas? I can't remember what they're called either.
Friend of mine
called America did Chernobyl.
I house hat for a friend of mine, and that was like what was on her keys. There was like a mini version of it, and it wasn't like it wasn't an operating one because
an operating one.
Well, like you couldn't open it up because otherwise you'd
be operational. This wooden doll.
Well, no, it wasn't. You couldn't open it up. Like you couldn't. There's no smaller ones inside of it. Anyways, she told me what it was.
That's the shittiest fucking Russian nesting doll.
It was just a fucking souvenir, and it would be a terrible keychain if you could open up and fall the fuck everywhere you put it.
You could screw it closed.
You're right. You're right, Aaron. You're always right.
Well, the it has one purpose, and that's to open up and have a smaller thing inside
of it. Maybe
it
has more than one purpose. Who knows? Maybe it's meaningful to this person.
My favorite part about this is Jordan.
Like having a bottle opener that doesn't open bottles.
Yeah, well, that's most bottle openers anyways.
I like that ceiling. That's pretty cool.
You can't, Yeah, that's the Chernobyl up there, see?
That was 0.2 femtoseconds after the blast.
I give that ceiling a 3.6 or whatever. Is that what it was? I didn't watch the show.
3.4. Not great, not terrible.
No.
That did nothing.
It just debuffs him a little bit. And staggers him.
Nothing's better than buff debuff.
Fuck your shield.
So, I played Ultimate Alliance 3.
Is that the one?
Is that a fighting game?
It's the one for Switch. Oh. Yeah. It's like the original Marvel Ultimate Alliance.
Can you break your shield in this?
It's not great. It's really not great. It's not like the original ones where, like... The first one was the best because there was, like, little Easter eggs everywhere you go, and, like, the map wasn't, like... I don't know. There was a bunch of secrets in the maps and all that stuff, and, like, you could get...
Laptop.
You could do comic book trivia and, like, all of this cool little mini Easter egg-y stuff. This one is, like... It's so cut and dry. And the best thing about the original ones was, like, if you...
It was a cool room.
If you did, a specific mission with a specific character, and you talk to another character, they might have a unique interaction. Like, that was one of the really cool things about the original one. And none of that stuff exists in this game.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah. And it sucks because it's out for the Switch only. And I feel like that's probably a big part of it, because it's probably a pretty low-budget game.
I would imagine yes as well. Yep. Yeah. So, nobody gives a fuck about those games anymore.
I wish they did, because, like, they have the potential to be some of the better... Well, they're... Like, it's like a Diablo-style game.
Yeah.
And, like, it'd just be so cool if they did a Diablo... Like, actually Diablo meets fucking Avengers. You know? Like, I don't want to play it for 70 hours... To have to unlock a fucking different uniform.
Not James Bond.
Oh my god. Is that George Washington?
He was in the Russian consulate the whole time.
Why is it giving me this bag? That's awful.
Have you picked up anything of use since we played episodes ago?
I mean, to be fair, Aaron is so ridiculously high level in this, he's probably not going to get that very many drops.
I have a particular build, so I haven't bothered picking up anything, but I probably have gotten some decent drops, yes. I haven't picked up anything.
Wow.
Other than stuff the game has given me. Wow. And I currently, like, if I just go into here, I already have 6 caches that I haven't opened because I don't have inventory space for it anymore.
Wow. That was my Owen Wilson.
Wow.
That was fucking terrible.
Somebody shared a screenshot of his Twitter where
he tried to kill himself.
Did he?
Jesus Christ.
When did that happen?
I don't know, like 10 years ago.
No, he was, somebody showed a picture of him and Jackie Chan from, was it Shaolin Knights? Was that their movie?
No, it was Around the World in 80 Days.
I thought it was Shanghai Nights.
Yeah, Shanghai Nights, sorry.
Oh, no, the whole fucking thing about that movie wasn't... Didn't they do something about... Didn't anybody go up in a balloon in it?
Anyway, the meme was, remember these two from Shaolin Nights?
Shanghai Nights.
Shanghai Nights, whatever.
I think there was a seat.
Here it is now. Here they are now. Feel old yet? It was Trump and fucking Kim Jong-un. And then Owen Wilson, his response was, wow. I don't know if it was real or not, but it was fucking hilarious.
That would be amazing.
Wow. Was that the sequel? Or is that what it was called?
Shaolin Noon was the first one. Shaolin Nights was
Shaolin
the,
Noon?
Yeah, was it
Shanghai Noon?
Shanghai Noon and Shanghai.
Okay, because I don't know where you're getting Shaolin from.
But it's spelled with. It wasn't K N I G T S. It was N I G H T S.
No, it was K N.
What the fuck? We gotta IMDb this shit.
Go this way.
Because it took place in London. That's why it's called Shanghai or Shaolin, whatever.
Like, it's Shanghai. It's not Shaolin.
I don't give a flying fuck. It's not a great movie.
What's Shaolin?
Shaolin is
a terrible anime.
Well, no, it's probably. Also... I think it's also Shaolin.
If it was a terrible anime, it'd be called, like, Shaolin Code 3000 or something.
No, it would be called something like Shaolin Code 3000, Never Through the Eververse, Destiny,
that
Destiny
actually
kind of
makes sense.
2.
It'd be like Never Run a Black
Shaolin
Face
is
or something.
Shaolin is a bunch of movies...
Shade tech.
Yeah, so I think there's it's. I know there's Shaolin is a big name in like kung fu movies. I don't know where the term comes specifically. Sorry, Communist Party of China, I've let you down again. You've taken a great historic country and ruined it.
So it's Shanghai Noon, and I need to find the other one now.
Shanghai Nights.
But I want to know if it's spelled with.
I'm pretty sure it's K.
It is. You're right. And. It came out in 2003, which is 16 years ago. Isn't that fucked?
Back in 2003, I still had hope. I still could have been a good person. I still could have, like, made something in my life. I'm not in the mess I am now.
But you were, like, 12.
Yeah, I know. I had the whole world ahead
you
of
had
me.
No hope.
Yeah, fair enough.
That's when you discovered masturbation.
That is around when I discovered masturbation, yes.
And you haven't stopped saying it's crazy.
Good for you. Nope.
The first porn I ever stumbled across was I was on the website Newgrounds, which is a very old statement, and
are you 60?
I was looking at anime like Dragon Ball Z videos that people had made of their own fan animations, and I went out and I saw that there was an adult section. I'm like, oh, I bet this is where they keep the really violent stuff.
Of course.
Hopped on and I'm like, what is this? What's going on here? I don't know.
That's not how bunny rabbits do it.
And that's when the devil consumed Adam.
Mm. I think the devil consumed YouTube as well.
Never to be...
It has consumed YouTube, and I don't know what we're going to do about it.
Oh yeah, but I didn't give a fuck.
Yeah, but they signed their soul to the devil long ago.
I invented masturbation.
Bloody Sunday, or whatever the fuck that song is.
Sunday, bloody Sunday.
Well...
It wouldn't be an episode with me unless both of us sang horribly. So.
Yeah. Also, can the cranberries just fucking stop?
They're dead. She's dead.
There you go. You got your wish.
Yes, Dolores is dead.
How'd she die?
She fucking died from an overdose.
Oh, well. Sorry to hear that. I didn't like her music.
Jesus Christ.
Well, you got your wish, Adam.
I thought she was still alive.
How does it feel?
It feels pretty bad.
How does
I gotta
it
be
feel
honest.
To be responsible for killing the cranberries, which aren't the great berry? You gotta be honest.
They're pretty good on turkey, though.
Yeah, they're all right. Baked apples and partridge. Yeah, also, fuck off, please.
What's the drug she OD'd on?
Dolores O'Riordan. I can't pronounce her actual name.
I just hate her fucking voice. She's
Dolores
so shrieky.
O something. So her initials backwards are OD.
Oh my God! She drowned.
Oh,
but
oh.
I think it was in her bathtub.
Missed
yeah,
opportunity
following sedation
there.
By alcohol intoxication.
Oh, problem. Oh, there you go.
Zombie. I fucking hate that song.
To all you kids, they're doing lines. Don't do it. Don't do it.
Jesus.
As an actual zombie, cranberry song.
That's terrible sounding.
To all those kids with heroin.
Anyway,
on
that brings us to the end of this episode.
I am sorry that she's dead, though. I understand that she had her fans. I'm not one of them. Very sorry that she passed away.
They were a progressive band from Ireland, which...
There aren't many bands
that have done well from Ireland in the grand scheme
of successes. Obviously she has her fans, I just don't like her fucking voice.
That's fine, but she did do a lot of good things, and I don't want anyone to fucking downplay that, okay? She had a lot of good things to say.
I'll lay off the Cranberries if you lay off Superman.
But Superman is a piece of shit.
Fuck off.
Doesn't matter.
Superman is better than the Cranberries.
We got one mission left.
Do you want to just do it?
We can.
Yeah, let's just do it and get this over with.
Alright, well, we'll see you next time, everybody.
Alright.
We're gonna wrap this game up.
See you in a week!